Welcome back to my channel. If you are new here, I'm Kenny. Make sure you subscribe to my channel. I will really appreciate that. And if you enjoyed this video, please don't forget to give me a thumbs up. In today's video, I'll be sharing with you this easy bantu knot out tutorial. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you do, please don't forget to give me a thumbs up and also subscribe to my channel. Please make sure you are subscribed to my channel. I'll really appreciate that. You can also press that bell beside the subscribe button so you are notified of my new uploads. Anytime I have a new video up there, you'll be the first to get the notification. This is my first successful bantu knot out since I've been completely natural. When I was transitioning to natural hair, this is one of my go-to styles then because it's easier for me to do it on my transitioning hair because the ends of my hair are straight and the roots of my hair are kinky. So it's one of the easiest hairstyle for me to do then, to stretch my hair out and also to give me curls without my hair looking kind of weird, something like that. So I used to do this a lot then, but now that I've been completely natural, this is my second attempt at it. The first time I did it, I used gel and I used a lot of product on it. My hair came out very dry. It took forever to dry and with a lot of flakes in my head. It's because of the gel I used. So I'll be giving you some tips. If you are doing bantu knot out, make sure you are not doing it on soaking wet hair. Make sure you don't use a lot of product because it may take a long time to dry. And also make sure you are not using gel. If you use gel, there's likely that it will take a longer time to dry. There is likely that your hair will come out very dry and frizzy, and there is higher likelihood that your hair will flake if you use gel. I'm just talking from my own experience and from the first few bantu knots out I had, because those are the things that I felt made the hairstyle feel. So I think with a couple of more attempts I can perfect my bantu knot out, but right now I think I'm okay with how it came out since this is my first successful bantu knot out since I've been completely natural. Okay guys, don't forget to give me a thumbs up, don't forget to subscribe to my channel, don't forget to leave me a nice comment in the comment section below, don't forget to share this video with anybody you think it's gonna be of help to. Thank you guys, and I'll catch you in my next video. Bye guys.
Okay guys, so I'm going to start on my dry and stretched hair. I'll start by putting my hair in sections so it's easier to work with. And I'm spritzing that section of hair with warm water. And I have to really work the water into it because like I always say, when my hair is dry, it's always very difficult for it to pick up anything. And I'm going to add olive oil to add some shine and also seal the moisture from the water into my hair. Like I said in intro, if you use too much products for bantu knot, it's gonna flake and take forever to dry. So I'll take that subsection of hair, and as my styler, I'll be using the Curl Enhancing Smoothie from Sheer Moisture. I'm taking just a little bit of that and I'm applying it, even though it's so much, I'm applying it to my hair, and I'm gonna detangle my hair with that pink comb. And I'll start swirling my hair. As you can see, I held on to the roots of my hair so that I didn't like put too much pressure on the roots of my hair while swirling it. I swirled my hair from the roots down to the tip, and I'll make a loop. Then I'll start wrapping the swirled hair around the loop that I created. Like I said, you want to leave so much, you want to leave a little bit of space between your scalp and the roots, because if you make it too tight, or if you twirl your hair from the roots, it can be so hard on the scalp and you may hurt your scalp when you do that, something like that. So I'm going to show you that again. Cool. I'm going to take this subsection of hair, I'll apply the styler, which is the Sheer Moisture Coconut and Hibiscus Curl Enhancing Smoothie. I'll swirl this hair till I get to the end. Then I'm gonna form like a loop like that, and I'll start wrapping the remainder of the hair around that loop that I created to form a bantu. So it's very, very simple. It's just like practice makes perfect. Once you know how to twirl your hair, just wrap it around. But be careful when you are forming that loop or when you are twirling your hair. Don't start from the roots of your hair because it can hurt your scalp if it's too tight. So I'm going to show you that again. I apply the styler, detangle that hair, form a loop, and I'm going to be wrapping the swirled hair around the loop that I created to form a bantu. So that is Faye's head right there. So I'm going to show you that again for the last time. So this is my hair once I finished Bantu knotting. This thing takes forever, to be honest. My arms were hurting me before I could finish Bantu knotting the whole of my head. And again, because my hair is so much and my head is big. So this is like 2 days after my Bantu knots. I make sure that they are completely dry before I start sticking them down. So I start by applying olive oil to my palm and I just like pull the Bantu knot to unravel it, and that is what my hair is looking like. So it's very simple. I just pull the Bantu knot to unravel it. It's very, very simple. It doesn't even take me much time before I unraveled every of the Bantu knot. I'm going to secure it with hair bands before I start separating it so that I can tend to every bit of the hair on my head like I always do with most of my styles. So I'll start separating each Bantu knot out to about 3 to 4 sections. I don't want it to be too much because I don't want to lose the curl definition I got. I want my hair to be big and at the same time I want to have some curl definition. That wiry curl definition, I want to retain it. That is the reason I'm not separating it too much. Even though in some of the hair I went overboard and I saw it in there, those places I went overboard with separating it, I had more frizz in those areas, especially on the ends of my hair. I have more frizz on the ends of my hair, which is understandable. Once I'm done separating each Bantu knot, I'll pick the roots of my hair with this pin comb. I'm making sure and I'm being very careful to make sure that I'm not picking my hair halfway. I make sure to pick only the roots of my hair to avoid frizz of any sort. But I didn't like how flat and how too shiny it's looking. I wanted to create more volume and bring more texture into it from the roots of my hair. Is the reason I picked it this much. So this is what my hair is looking like. It's looking curly and like telephone wire kind of curly, which I really love. If you enjoyed this video, please don't forget to give me a thumbs up, don't forget to subscribe to my channel, and don't forget to leave me nice comments in the comment section below.